everyone, and welcome to this first bond moment of 2023. The last shall be the first. This could apply to emerging countries, which are experiencing a real comeback in the bond market. Emerging countries were scarce in 2022, but the tide has turned, and in less than 3 weeks, they have issued more than $40 billion, i.e. more than 40% of what they issued in the whole of last year. Not only investors have licked their wounds, but their appetite for risk, both credit and duration, is back. Priority is given to high-quality issuers such as Saudi Arabia, Hungary, Romania, the Philippines, Indonesia, and Mexico. And this does not prevent riskier issuers such as Turkey or Mongolia to finance themselves easily. So how can this change in mood be explained? There are many factors. China's reopening, the trend towards disinflation, hopes of avoiding a recession, and central banks that may be approaching a pause in their rate hike cycle. And bond investors, hungry for attractive absolute yields not seen for a decade, are there. Duration is no longer a concern, as the example of Saudi Arabia demonstrated. While the kingdom was thinking of issuing between $5 and $7 billion, order books of $35 billion pushed them to issue $10 billion over three maturities. Initial indication of the risk premiums for the 30-year maturity were 210 basis points, but the bond was issued at 170. 40 basis points is not so trivial, since it corresponds to an interest expense savings for the issuer of $390 million over the life of the bond. The bond continued to perform well in the secondary market, with its price rising from 92.70 to 97. The credits that made the market skittish also last year are coming back in the favor. The example of Turkey is telling. The country managed to issue a 10-year bond with a yield 25 points lower than what it had to concede in November for a maturity of 5.5 years, 9.75% against 10%. Does this mean that investors are buying blindly? No. Because the doors are not open for countries in difficulty like Ghana, Zambia, or Ethiopia. So what about Mongolia's success? A new $450 million bond received an enthusiastic response, and so its price soared from 98.80 to 104.50 in 1 week. The success was due to a liability management program with little new cash that led to a controlled increase in net debt while successfully reducing short-term refinancing risk. Finally, while the premiums offered for new issues are attractive and are probably swelling the order books, the market is hungry without having no ears. Thank you.